this country that they don't.
So you joined when you were fighting for other
people? I was, yeah. I was
part exactly of MSAS.
I was in Africa. Yeah, I was. I protected because police brutality comes to Africa. Now, this kind of legislation can affect anybody. You can just come and say, poor people should not be able to come to this side of town.
No, they are already making another proposal, which is part of what we are talking about, this extreme mental health problem of leaders. I think it's the NDLA chairman, Marwa, saying that you have to obtain a drug risk certificate before you can get married. Do you understand? This is the same guy who was Lagos State Governor.
Yes.
Stole huge amount of money in Lagos. He used it to set up an airline. And nobody asked him to get a drug free certificate before he became a public official. So they are going to go anywhere as long as they have this free latitude and bandwidth to just enact laws. One day they will enact a law that says you can't be.
Yes, exactly.
So that you cannot go to. This country is already an apartheid state. Apart from, I said that the apartheid is between the rich and the poor, the powerful and the strong and the weak. It's already an apartheid state. And that is why they just use whatever they can. And like you rightly said, there's still a lot of people who have also been brainwashed to believe that, being gay is evil, and all those kind of things. Well, being corrupt is not evil, right? Being oppressive is not evil. Being a bandit is not evil. Being a kidnapper is not evil. Being a very, very serious, corrupt official who will steal the money meant for children, people who sell employment slots, those ones are not evil.
Being a pedophile.
A pedophile is not evil. We've had people who married
8-year-olds, 7-year-olds, 13-year-olds
in this country, 17-year-olds, people who don't have the consent to get married. They don't go after those ones. These people, adults, who are consenting to the sexual lifestyle that they believe is acceptable to them. Yes. What is that? What's the problem?
We're asking the chef, what
don't you know me? Why are you harassing me? What's the problem?
What's the problem?
Is this not a public place? That's all. You are law enforcement agents. You are mere citizens.
What is happening? Then we expect
we are citizens. You are law enforcement agents. We are citizens.
In polite way, not that.
No. You are the one who is not talking to us in a polite way.
You came as you just started.
You just came here, just came out of the car. See, having a gun is the end of the world.
I tried to video us.
No, we are actually doing a video. Yes, you ran into the video. Law enforcement agents does not confer on you the right to harass anybody.
You shouldn't harass people.
It's not a matter of harass.
No, it's harassment.
That is what you just did.
We are citizens. We are sitting on the curb. You just jump out of the car because you have a gun. Yes, and you are saying you are law enforcement agents.
See, we are all the same. Whether you are from Northeast, whether you are from South.
We are, nobody's arguing about that. We are Nigerians. But what we are telling you is that the manner of just jumping out of a car, a HILOS van with a gun, saying, "What are you doing there?" It's not acceptable. We must learn to respect ourselves. We must learn that.
As we come down, do you show any bad attitude against you?
You showed bad attitude
you
towards
did.
Me. Yes, you did. Because you jumped out of the car.
What are you doing? Sorry, may I know you, sir?
My name is Omoyele Showore.
Then what are you doing here?
I'm here protesting. And it's my right.
Well, permitted to.
We don't need permission
to permit to protest.
Wow,
you are a police officer.
Wow,
you should know.
You should know better. If you don't know, go to the legal department of the police.
You don't need any permission
and
to protest.
They will tell you that there's no need for any permit to protest. Even if there was need for permit to protest, we will violate that permit because
of course,
it's a fundamental human right to protest against laws that are unjust. Does that make sense?
Any action you want to take, let authority know. That
which authority?
Authority?
The same authority that is, responsible for that the people that we want us to go to, the people we are protesting against.
Can I say something?
You are doing your job now.
He's
a reporter. He could video you.
I don't concur with what you are trying to do.
You are a public officer. You have found yourself doing public work. You run into a video. Even if you didn't run into a video, we will still video you so that we can capture the interaction we are having.
Excuse me, sir. Can I make something clear?
You can make something clear.
Yes, I was initially here alone. I'm on a one-man protest. I'm on a hunger strike against a bill that passed through this National Assembly. So they came to show support. So originally I was here alone, and I'm going to be here. I will keep being here alone. Till
sexual orientation.
Yes.
It's not a crime.
There is There's a current law that
sexual orientation is not a crime. What is the meaning of this statement now?
This is very clear, and I'll be able to explain. You need to explain to you.
Sexual orientation.
Yes.
It's not a crime.
It's not a crime. To have a sexual orientation that is different from the one that you are used to from is not a crime.
That's is it gay or
whichever or one?
Yeah, LGBT, all of them.
Gay, bisexual, transgender, whichever one.
Even if you're straight, it's also a sexual orientation.
If you are not from either Christian home, you are from Muslim home.
Was everybody be a Muslim and a Christian?
Everyone is not limited to only Christianity and Islam.
Excuse me, sir.
Before Christianity and Islam came to Africa, was there no religion?
Traditional religion, they no support gay.
Traditional religion.
The same
traditional religion that keeps people
high. Nigeria
is a secular state. Nigeria is not a theocracy.
Traditional religion, I don't have any God fearing. More than any other religion.
Officer, Nigeria is a secular state.
So because of that, people have no right to have sexual preferences.
Do you know why Sodom and Gomorrah was totally brought down?
Were you there?
Excuse me, that's not the point. The problem is the point. That's not why I'm not
there.
Were you there? But, Mr. Shaw, I beg you in the name of God,
yes,
please, we don't want any inscription written on the,
there will
on
not
the
be
walls.
Which inscription are you afraid of?
No, just let us be friendly with ourselves.
No, you don't have to be friendly with me. Now. I'm asking you which one.
Wait.
So you are scared of this one.
Okay, now tell me, why are you scared of this?
Why are you scared of this one?
See, they are even written on the wall.
Where?
Which is totally prohibited.
Where
is it prohibited?
I beg you.
So you are the people who have been going around cleaning those things. If we catch you,
I beg you.
We will sue you to court.
I beg you in the name of God.
The people who are doing those things,
those people are doing
a lot of investment.
Officer, the thing is, some other time, this man might be here alone. You people shouldn't harass him.
No, they know that now.
This one, you are not after.
He has the right to fight. Whether you are a Christian and you don't support him, it doesn't concern anyone.
Let him go. We don't want it to
go.
That one, when we are ready, you people go and get ready for that one.
We don't want it to be written.
When we are ready for that one,
I'm tired. Give me today. Because I did on duty today.
So you don't want it to be on duty. Now, I'm going to clean them, Abby. Now, I'm going to clean the ones with
you.
Let's friendly with ourselves, please.
I am a very friendly person now.
Try to be civil with citizens.
It is you people and your guard that needs to be civil.
This inscription written.
It doesn't matter. People have the right to inscribe whatever they like anyway.
Help us stop it.
And it's not possible. As long as you have that man he's not doing his job. He's killing Nigerians. Nigerians have a right to demand for him to go.
Tell the police to stop harassing Nigerians and LGBTQ people.
How far now?
My sexual orientation is not a crime, Abby.
Yes, that is. Please also write the thing below. This is the bill.
This is the law he's protesting against.
Yeah, that's why you're writing it down, sir.
I will report to my superior. Tell them to call me.
Say you see me here.
We're preparing for the main showdown. The main showdown is Buhari must go.
Anyhow,
we are changing the system.
The system is
so that your children can have a secured future. Or wouldn't you like your children having a secured future?
Why not?
Good. So that's what we're doing.
Repeal.
So that they have their rights.
They should repeal.
Now, they're supposed to even protect the way they
do. This one repealed the law.
Repeal, yeah, the law was passed under President Jonathan. So they should repeal it.
Okay, you don't like one of these two.
We'll take one.
What is it?
Give your daughter or your son now.
Where I'm under this
shirt. Just no matter shirt.
revolution. I dey fear to wear am.
Go give your daughter now.
This one don't pass my power. So tell your officers to stop harassing LGBTQ people, gay people.
Maybe we need change of clothes. It's revolutionary. Because but if you feel like you should stay here, we'll keep it. No, I'm just saying in case you need change of clothes, I'll just give it to you. Let's make sure they leave before.
Yeah.
So they are going around looking for evil roads.
Yeah. We know those ones. Now they go
tired. Look at what.
As the,
instead of me, they relocate, go Zamfara.
With taxpayers' money.
Go to Kaduna where there's security problem. They are hunting people who are right
there. They look too tired.
How far now?
Okay.